Cassie Hi. Today. And this is our grandpa. Today, yep. We're going to read you a story. Yeah, but if you have the same book, then go and get it and read with us. We're going to show you the cover.
Okay, excellent.
That's the cover.
All right. It's time to read now.
Yeah.
It says...
And we'll show you the pictures.
Yes.
The Tooth Fairies Secret.
Oh.
By Dane Sorensen. Illustrated, that means drawings, by Adria Sorensen.
That's, so the one who writes the words is this guy.
Uh-huh.
And then our auntie put the pictures in. See you guys.
And it says dedicated to Snow White, that's a nickname for Grandma Candy. And the kidlets and grandkidlets, that's you guys. And then to Cassie and Teddy, love Grandpa Dane. Now you, somewhere you've got this at your house. And you, if you don't remember, you can ask your mom when you get home.
I haven't seen it in a very long time.
Oh, but you do remember it?
Mm-mm,
oh.
I
didn't. Well, I gave it to you when you were really, really small.
So,
all right, here we go. Anita rushed off the bus with her precious cargo in her lunch pail. She couldn't wait to show her mom and dad. "Daddy, I lost a tooth," shouted Anita as she flew through the door. It came out during recess. "Whoa, let's see," said her dad. Anita smiled a big smile, and sure enough, there was a big gap where her front tooth was supposed to be. And you guys have lost teeth, haven't you? Yeah. Oh my goodness, my little girl is falling apart. I'm going to have to glue your tooth back in or exchange you for a new little girl at the store.
Oh no!
I wonder if I still have the receipt, said her dad with a bigger smile. Do you think he's really gonna trade her in?
No.
I think he was just joking.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah.
Now we saw the pictures. This is the pictures.
Yeah, that's a beautiful school bus. All right.
Okay, we're going to go back to our seats. Before we
Oh, Daddy, don't be silly. My tooth is supposed to fall out. I put it in my lunchbox. Now I can leave it under my pillow for the Tooth Fairy. Anita opened her lunchbox and showed her small baby tooth to her dad and then ran off to show Mommy. Isn't this exciting, Mom? Now I will get money for my lost tooth. How much do you think the Tooth Fairy will leave?
One.
I'm not sure, Anita dear. I think your dad is the expert on tooth fairies. Why don't you ask him while I finish planting these flowers?
You don't know what thing.
Oh, I'm not done with the page.
Let's go back to
Anita went to her parents' home office, which was in the basement of their home. Her mom and dad worked for companies far away. They were able to work at home instead of driving to an office building. Anita still held the tooth in her hand and asked her dad, "How much money do you think I'll get from the Tooth Fairy?" "That depends," said her father, "on how good you are. Good things happen to good girls, you know." "I've been told," said Anita, "but will I get lots and lots of money?" Anita's dad turned away from his computer and pulled her up on his lap. He told her that as candy and toys become more expensive, the Tooth Fairies have been nice enough to leave more money. He said when he was a boy, he always got 50 cents. Today, if a child is really, really good, they get a whole dollar. "Wow," beamed Anita. "I'll be able to buy a zillion candy bars with a dollar." Anita jumped down and twirled around as if candy bars were falling from the sky. Okay, go ahead and show the picture.
Don't do that.
Okay. Not quite a zillion, but maybe two at the grocery store when we go next time. Do you know why tooth fairies want your tooth? I don't know, Daddy. Do they use them for fake teeth like grandma's? No, said her daddy with a chuckle. They don't use them to make dentures. That's what fake teeth are called, dentures. They would be too small for grown-ups and too big for fairies. The tooth fairies do need baby teeth. It is important to them as food and water are to you. Do they eat them, Daddy? Asked Anita with a funny look on her face. Would you want to eat a tooth? No, I don't think baby teeth taste good, said her dad. Anita's dad set her on his lap and told her he had once heard a story when he was a little boy from her grandfather.
I don't know what's going to happen. Wait. Oh,
you want to show? Oh, yeah, you already showed that picture.
Yeah.
He had asked his father when he was young why tooth fairies spent so much time and money collecting teeth. I will tell you, Anita, what your grandfather told me. Anita listened as her dad began to tell her grandfather's mysterious story. It says grandfather's story. Tooth fairies are very lucky. They are born with wings. Even though no one has ever seen them, we know they do exist. Fairies are very small, no taller than your hand, and on their backs are small crystal wings that look like thin glass. Look, they're in the flowers. Isn't that cute?
Yeah. Did you know that the fairies were born in flowers?
Yeah, and they sleep in them too. You want to go show that picture?
No, read that stuff.
We'll read that next. Let's show the picture of the flowers.
Does anyone like this?
Yeah.
Let's show them the other one. That's the cover.
We haven't read that page yet.
Yeah, and we on the other side, there, that picture is the cover.
Yeah, and it matches the cover.
Okay. Come on, Auri. We'll read more.
Yeah, you get good. You're too pretty.
Fairies live in hidden places. No one has ever seen their homes. Some people think they live up in the clouds. Others think they sleep during the day in unopened flower buds deep in the forest. Still others think that fairies live in secret places that are like beehives, except that there is only fairies and lots of sweet things. When tooth fairies fly, their wings glow with tiny sparkles. Those sparkles are from the fairy dust. Without fairy dust, their wings would become dark and useless. They need fairy dust every day, or else they can't fly. Fairies are like any other creature on Earth. They must work for their living. When you work, you not only help yourself and help everyone by making the world a better place. It is the same for tooth fairies. The fairies work very hard. Every night they go and find coins or dollars that careless children or grown-ups have lost. People lose money all the time. They may drop it accidentally. Some lose money when they get a hole in their pocket. Some lose it on purpose when they make a wish in a pond or a fountain. Fairies find the money and then use it to reward good children who have lost a tooth. The nicer the child, the more money they get. If you're mean and say bad things all the time, it will make your tooth worthless. You'll be lucky if you get a penny. Oh, pennies you can't buy anything with. Fairies can tell in the dark how good you have been. A tooth from a good child sings to them.
Okay,
Auri. All right. Where was I?
You were so
A tooth from a good child sings to them. They can hear how good you were from your tooth as it lays under your pillow. After they take your tooth and leave your reward, they fly away and go back to their secret home. It is there that the real magic begins. The wise old fairies are in charge of turning your tooth into fairy dust. They weigh how much goodness is in it. If the young fairies have made a mistake and brought back a tooth with a cavity, they will throw it into the fire for fuel. Only the very best teeth are turned into fairy dust. It is a long and secret process. The tooth must be ground into fine powder. No one knows how it is done, but soon the tooth powder is turned into fairy dust. When it shines with a bright golden light, it is ready to be used. Only good things can come from good. The tooth fairies are lucky because there are plenty of good children in the world, and there are plenty of lost coins and dollars. As long as that remains true, there'll always be plenty of fairy dust and plenty of tooth fairies in the world. Can I show the picture?
But we've got presents to open.
We'll be out in a minute.
Okay. When we
finish.
Guys, do you see the money? Yeah. But don't worry. We're going to come back to this.
Okay. Here, let's finish the book. There's not much left.
Cent. Well, I might leave the video. I'm going to see what's going on up there. But I'll come back.
We'll miss you. I wish it was nighttime already, said Anita. I will stay up and watch for the Tooth Fairy. Then I can draw a picture and show everyone what one really looks like. Anita, Dad just smiled at his lovely daughter and said, let's go show your older sisters. I think they are home now. Later that night, Anita slept as she always sleeps. She did not see the Tooth Fairy, but she certainly knew they really did exist when she woke up. Oh my, look at all the money she got. Did you show that picture?
Yeah.
This one?
Yeah. And we showed the money.
Yeah. All right.
La, 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 la.
And that's
la, la,
the end. La, la, la. And there's a picture.
Let's go and show the pictures.
Of me,
Grandpa,
and Adria.
Adria. There you go, everyone. The end. Bye-bye. Bye bye. Let's go.
All right, that's great. Bye-bye.